just for people who aren't here.
Okay, so you guys are just ready?
Right.
You're going to write stuff. So the class is going to shoot ideas at me, and I'm going to sort of give you, tell you like where on the line something of their ideas. What makes people happy?
Food.
All right, food. That's me, way down at the bottom.
Yeah, double high five.
Yeah, right there. So. Alcohol, Link, that's for you too.
Yeah, it is.
You got everything down there. I'm sorry, I didn't mean it that way. What makes people happy?
So family.
Family.
C-O.
Yeah, easy that way.
Yeah, to make sure.
Cool.
So Alyssa does family.
H-O-O-L.
What?
We don't know how to spell alcohol.
I want to make sure I don't look stupid.
He's got it. What is that? He just said something I think could relate to happiness. I want to make sure I don't look stupid. What's the good
sign? Smart, perfection.
Yeah.
Smart and perfection means you put that on top of the line. Smart and perfection. Don't put that up there. What else? What makes people happy?
Sleep.
Can you put that down there?
Financial wealth.
Work.
Financial wealth. Ooh, okay. Let's Alyssa, let's have you do work. That's interesting. Wealth.
Sports.
Okay. Now that's getting a little complicated. Maybe put
fitness.
Put fitness there, but a little higher up, more towards Alyssa.
Here.
Yeah. And let's put wealth. Maybe Alyssa, put wealth in your spot.
Fitness is alcohol and love.
Fitness.
Did you say right above the line?
Music.
Yeah, music.
Music. Alyssa, you do that one, but put it a little bit towards Meech.
Love.
Meech, you put that one on there. Pretty high up. And, yeah, like towards, like this is the high, this is the top. So put it over there. What else makes people happy? You guys are leaving out something really obvious.
Physical connection.
You want to just put sex?
Sure.
Right at the bottom. What do you mean? Yeah. Right. What else? What else makes people happy? We've got family, wealth, work.
Friends.
There you go.
Friends over there too. What's up?
Significant others.
Significant others? Let's put that under Alyssa's as well. Meech, you put friendship in your section. Friendship.
I see what you did there.
Let's talk about it. What is it?
You can have friends, but only certain friends have friendships with you. Kind of like, you can have like, I guess, soda, like diet soda, or some butterbeer, some not.
Now you know all y'all thinking like Aristotle. Remember Aristotle. What else makes people happy?
Success.
That is awesome. Let's do that.
Awesome and do success.
Meech, you write success kind of between me and Melissa.
Why are you saying that?
Sure.
Maybe write about you.
Success.
What?
Yeah.
It doesn't matter how close to the line is, just how high it is. What's the flip side of jealousy? Like, what's the opposite of jealousy?
Happiness.
Confidence, trust.
So put pride up here. Pride, that's for me. But it can be pride in yourself or in others. Would that be it?
Yeah.
Pride in yourself or others. Josh, what makes people happy?
Cook.
You got that already. How about freedom from pain?
Freedom.
Yeah. Oh yeah, no bills?
Freedom.
Well, freedom, what freedom up here?
Violence makes people happy. Some people like enjoy fighting and watching fights.
That's good. That's like sick.
Education.
Violence. As violence as entertainment.
Education.
Education. Put that up here. Education. This is a pretty good list. The next step is to examine the list and see how all these things are similar and different. So what? Why are they arranged in this particular way on the line? So maybe, Link, if you could sit over here,
okay,
or maybe over there by the marker box so Melanie and the Coleman sister can see what's on it. Bailey?
Is it because this side is more of the things that make you happy temporarily and then that's more long term?
That's a great way to put it. So we could put, maybe grab another color, Link, and put temporary here and long term here. Any other differences?
Maybe the happiness is ranged on what's more universally accepted as good, happy. Like, you can get pleasure from these things, but they might be taboo, whereas you've got wealth and success and love, and that's something that everybody outwardly claims to want.
Yeah. Meech, can you grab a different color? Like one we haven't used before. And put good at the top. I think Connor's observation was these things might be good or bad,
right,
depending on your perspective and how you use them. Because
right,
we can overeat or oversleep. Or
right, like
enough.
It says drugs there, but you could be addicted to heroin or you
good
could be
good
taking cancer medication, which
right
is which is good for you.
Right.
For you.
But these things are unadulteratedly good. That's a very interesting observation. Great, that's Connor. So the good is somehow defines all these. Plato would really appreciate that.
These are a lot easier to acquire. And they always take a lot more work and more risk and reward situations. So like the friendship thing, like you've worked with a friend for a while, then when they wake up, the $40 are missing in your heart. So it's like, you don't know who your friends are, and then you just lost a friend in your heart real quick.
You always come up with these colorful examples.
I mean, food and like drugs, like those are really good for you. Like money, so I mean.
You're willing to
put food
in
temporary section, right?
Yeah, that's tough.
Well, what do we put easy down there and hard up here? So put easy and put hard. But what that's saying, and this is very much part of Plato's philosophy and very important, is that the line is a process. Bless you. Do you need a cough drop? I've got some. We've got things that are easy to acquire that are like the first step. But then there's this process of growth, of movement, toward the things that are more enduring or long term, that are unadulteratedly good, but that are hard to acquire. Let me go find the cough drops. Or something that makes me happy.
One drop, Cole.
Yeah, comes under drugs.
Thank you.
Any thoughts about the similarities or differences among these things? So we've got, let me just read it off. Down at the bottom, we have entertainment, particularly violent entertainment.
Movies.
Drugs, alcohol, sleep, sex, food. All those things are temporary and easy to acquire. Moving further along, we've got fitness, family, work, wealth, friends, significant others, music. And then kind of at the top, we have pride, freedom, love, friendship, education, smart, perfection, success, and the good. So how are these things different?
In the amount of effort that it takes to acquire either one, like it, the way I'm seeing it is the stuff that, like, in the middle, like it starts off in the middle, and then you've got kind of like a right wing and left wing kind of good and bad situation, and that it all depends on your perspective. But you start off in the middle of things that come incredibly easy, like fitness, you go out and walk, like that's just a matter of you doing it. The music, you could be anywhere and hear it. Whereas the other stuff, like you go to one side that requires a ton of work with lasting results, and then the other side is, you know, not as much. And
so what we could put along the line
negative
is maybe work. Like, other stuff, just write the word work on the line. I mean, work is kind of what this represents.
Mm-hmm. Or progress.
Progress.
That's
a better work and progress. Yeah. Let's put both of those. And Plato would really, that's one of the main ideas he wants us to understand. Is that this is a process, it's a progress, something we have to work towards. enduring happiness is something we've got to work towards. Another way to look at it is these things are more material. These are things. You can see them, or touch them, or eat them. Our physical bodies and the things that we put into them, the desires that we fulfill are here. But these things, can you see? You can't see them. You can't see love. You can see a person who you love, but you can't see love itself. It's not a physical thing, but it's real. Same with friendship and education and pride and freedom. What are those things? What word do we use to describe all of this, that kind of thing? They're not physical objects. What are they?
Metaphor?
Material?
No.
Material?
Yeah, these are material. Drugs and food and alcohol, that's material. What are these?
Immaterial?
Well, they are immaterial, that's true. Yeah. Okay,
that's a word.
Plato would call them the ideas or the forms. So ideas, right? Nietzsche, can you write ideas in the big green marker at the top there? Ideas or forms. You can't touch them, see them, measure them. You cannot scientifically prove that they exist. There is no scientific evidence that something like freedom actually exists. Zero. But we believe that it's real. Human rights, that's another example. Everyone in this room, I would bet my right arm, believes that human rights are real. But as human beings, we all deserve respect and the conditions for life. There's no scientific evidence for that whatsoever. But it's real. It's an idea that we have. And Plato's fundamental conviction was the ideas are real. Not everybody believes in them. And along with that, that there's this process that you can go through to get to that level in your life, and that's how you'll find enduring happiness when you reach the top of that line.
Is it laid out? Here, the stuff that you could do on your own. Besides, well, you could have sex by yourself, but I'm assuming if it's with a person, it's selfless, like you're just utilizing that person, but the more you get closer to that, you get into it.
Purely good. A real friendship is never bad. And that is a good observation. Real love is never bad. So these are wonderful observations. I think we'll have to keep this online in the classroom at least for a few years. Thank you to our volunteers. You can leave that on the floor for now. All right, this is another way, it's just kind of a funny thing. Into this similar question.
Say what?
What if I think that this is pleasing?
You have low standards.
I mean, maybe that's kind of in a nutshell. We have a notion of a standard that something either meets or it does not. We have that notion in our minds. It's a concept or an idea. We've already used that word, so let's go ahead and use it again. We have an idea or a standard in our minds. Mathematical truths, that's very easy, right? Something's either right or wrong. Does anyone know the mathematical definition of a circle?
Point in the center, which is the distance from center to the edge, which is circumference, that's equal fully around, that's a circle.
In a nutshell, that's it. A circle is the set of points equidistant from the center points. There are an infinite number of lines I could draw, but all of them would be the same length. That is the definition of a circle. Once you've seen or grasped with your logos, your reason, the definition of that standard, then you can start to understand why something falls short of it or meets it. So Plato's notion is that we have ideas in our minds, and we know these ideas a priori, some of them. We know a priori, which means they're innate, they're inside of us before we were even born. So a circle is one example. Let's play around with a few more. And that's obvious with mathematical truths. Not so obvious with aesthetics. You have a word in that word. How about this? Ugly or beautiful?
Stop it.
Okay, so we have a certain idea in our minds of what beauty is, and the degree to which an individual person's body meets that or not. That's another notion, it's another idea that we have. Healthy or sick? Which body is healthy and which is not healthy?
Both of them.
You think this is healthy? That's pretty underweight. You guys are generous.
Yeah, that's pretty underweight. Let's get
I'm serious.
He's old.
Maybe for
So let me ask you this way. That makes it unhealthy. That's the thing.
We could have a conversation about which body was healthier.
I look underweight.
But what is what standard are we comparing that to?
You probably got the clue.
It would probably.
Yes, he's probably got steroids.
So there's some standard, Nicole just pointed out, there's a standard of health. And health can be physical or mental, right? We know that. Health is an idea. How we interpret or apply that idea to the concrete physical things might differ. But we all agree that health is something real we all strive for. So health is another example of an idea. And Plato was really into the notion that the body can be healthy or sick. So the soul can be healthy or sick. I think we talked about that in at least one of our seminars. Can we live having an evil and corrupted body? Of course not. How can we live having an evil and corrupted soul? In our next reading, Plato takes that to the level of society. How can we live having an evil and corrupted society? So he looks at that on another level. Just or unjust, a Palestinian family loses their home to an Israeli bulldozer. The Israelis just knocked over this house. Is that just or unjust?
Unjust.
Justice is when a family has a home and security and enough to live on. How do we know that? What is it that's deep inside of us that recognizes when a situation is just or unjust? There's no scientific proof of this. There's something inside of us. This Plato's deepest metaphysical conviction. Metaphysics is the science of what is really real. Metaphysics. I would put justice up here as well. It's one of those ideas. His deepest metaphysical conviction was that the ideas are real. They really exist, even though we can't see, touch, measure, or prove them. Or forms. In Greek, it's the word eide. You don't have to know that. But you can see it translated with either one of these English words. The ideas or forms are real. His epistemology is the science of how do human beings know? How do we know anything at all? How does knowledge come to us? What is it? Plato thought that we have a priori knowledge of many of these ideas. In other words, we're born with it. Before we experience anything, before we're taught anything by our parents or teachers, we already have this knowledge deep within us of some of these forms. So they're part of who we are. Not every philosopher shares that conviction. You might not share it, but this was Plato's idea. So who was Plato? To my knowledge, there's not that much information about his life. He's not a colorful figure like Socrates. He was a student and friend of Socrates, probably met Socrates in his youth, perhaps in his 20s. A source that I'm familiar with, his Introduction to Philosophy, says that Socrates was executed when Plato was 31. When he was still a young man. He was born into an aristocratic or upper class family and was expected to go into a career in politics. He did not. He chose to follow Socrates instead. And he founded an educational institution called the Academy in Athens, the city of Athens in Greece, which lasted for about 800 years. Famously, over the doorway to the academy, there was a sign that said,